Now this is illustration 69th. Circles. See, in this question, the equation of a circle is given, and it is mentioned that this circle is inscribed in a triangle whose two sides are coordinate axes, and third side is variable. That's the question. The circle is a given circle. You can see center is 2, 2, radius is also 2. Is inscribed in a circle, inscribed in a triangle whose two sides are x-axis and y-axis. Third side is variable, right? So we have to find locus of the circumcenter of triangle, locus of the circumcenter of triangle OAB. So this is circumcircle of triangle OAB, and we are supposed to find locus of the center of the circumcircle. And you know, as this angle is 90. This AB is the diameter of this circumcircle, right? Angle in a semicircle is a right angle, right? So if this angle is 90, this is semicircle. So we have to find locus of midpoint of this. Let it be P point. Let the coordinates of P point be x1, y1, right? So we have to find locus of midpoint of AB, because this midpoint of AB is the circumcenter of triangle OAB. Now the easier approach is we apply r equals to delta by s formula, where r is in radius, this is area of the triangle, and this is semi-perimeter. So you can see if the coordinates of midpoint are x1, y1, we can write coordinates of A as 2x1, 0, and that of B as 0, 2, y1. So you know this formula: midpoint is x1, y1, then x-intercept is 2x1, and y-intercept is 2y1. Now, in this triangle and in circle, we apply this property. Radius is 2, radius of the incircle is 2. Area of this circumscribing triangle is half base, that is 2x, 2x1, height is 2y1. And there is no need to put mod sign, because this triangle is in first quadrant, because circle lies in first quadrant. So x1 is going to be positive, y1, so area like y1 is going to be positive, right? Divided by semi-perimeter. Semi-perimeter means length of this side, length of OA, 2x1, OB, 2y1, plus AB, root of Pythagoras theorem, root of 4x1 square plus 4y1 square divided by 2. Semi-perimeter, it means we have to divide by 2. So you can see there is no changing parameter, so no elimination part. This is a locus. Just have to simplify, we get this locus. Now the alternate approach of this question is a little difficult than this. Let's try to apply that. We have to find the locus of this midpoint x1, y1. So x-intercept is 2x1, y-intercept is 2y1. So we can write equation of AB. Can remove this. So we're discussing alternate approach. In alternate approach, we write equation of AB. Using intercept form, x by 2x1, y by 2y1 equals to 1. And then we apply condition of tangency. If this line touches this inscribed circle, then center then distance of center 2, 2 from this line, perpendicular distance of center 2, 2 from this line should be equal to radius. That is condition of tangency. So we find distance of point 2, 2 from this line. So we apply distance formula. And equate it to radius 2. Now, see, this is like generally what we do. If we get this, we take square to remove square root and to remove mod sign, and we get locus. But this time, the form of the locus is given. And in form of the locus, if you have a look at that, we cannot take square because it is in the square root form. And we don't have to find locus, we have to find the value of k. We have to find, locus is given, we have to find the value of k. So it means we cannot take square. If we cannot take square, then because we have to retain the mod sign, so we, instead of mod hata ke, we put plus minus here. but the problem is that if you take plus minus, we're getting two values of k. One is 1, one is 1, other is minus 1. So plus minus 1. So is this answer correct? K equal to plus minus 1, which we are getting from this plus minus sign. No, this answer is not correct. Only one value is correct. One value is correct just because we got two values, because condition of tangency will be satisfied by this circle as well as another circle, that is a circumscribed circle. This circumscribed circle is also touching x-axis, y-axis and this line, tangent. So in inscribed circle is touching coordinate axis and this line. Inscribed circle is also touching coordinate axis and this line. So we are getting both the values. We are getting two values of k. One is for inscribed, other is for circumscribed. Now we need to eliminate. That's the difficult part here. We need to eliminate the value that we don't want to take here. So now see, we need to decide the which value of k is the correct value. For that, we need the, or we can say we need the value of k which is for the inscribed circle, not the inscribed one. So for that, what we do, we apply the concept position of a line, position of a point with respect to a line. So for this line, we define this expression. And you know, points lie, those points which lie on the same side of this line will have the same sign of this expression. Points lying on the same side of this line will have same sign of this expression. And sign of origin, what is the sign of? If you replace 0, 0 to check sign of origin, it is minus 1. Negative. Now we want that case, we want inscribed case. In inscribed cases, like the one when 2, 2 lies on the origin side of this line, whereas center of the inscribed circle is on other side of this line. So when we replace 2, 2 here, we should get the same sign as the sign of the origin. So replace 2, 2 here, we get 2 by 2 x1 plus 2 by 2 y1 minus 1. And this should be less than 0 because sine of origin is negative. Now what we got from here is this expression is negative. And if this expression is negative, means, you know, let's come back here. This is positive. This is positive. This expression is negative, just we figured out that. So there should be a negative sign outside instead of plus minus. So that this negative and this negative becomes plus. Right? Because you cannot equate negative quantity to a positive quantity. If this part is positive, this part should also be positive. So this we have figured out is negative. So we choose negative in front, so that it becomes positive. So we could remove one of the two signs. There's just one sign here. So we'll get only one value of k from this side. And the value we'll get is k equal to 1.